In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to this Mass here at St. Denis Catholic Church in Diamond Bar, California, as we celebrate on this Saturday in the sixth week of Easter. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let's first acknowledge our sins. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Constantly shape our minds, we pray, O Lord, by the practice of good works, that, trying always for what is better, we may strive to hold ever fast to the Paschal mystery. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After staying in Antioch some time, Paul left and traveled in orderly sequence through the Galatian country and Phrygia, bringing strength to all the disciples. A Jew named Apollos, a native of Alexandria, an eloquent speaker, arrived in Ephesus. He was an authority on the scriptures. He had been instructed in the way of the Lord and with ardent spirit spoke and taught accurately about Jesus, although he knew only the baptism of John. He began to speak boldly in the synagogue, but when Priscilla and Aquila heard him, they took him aside and explained to him the way of God more accurately. And when he wanted to cross to Achaia, the brothers encouraged him and wrote to the disciples there to welcome him. After his arrival, he gave great assistance to those who had come to believe through grace. He vigorously refuted the Jews in public, establishing from the scriptures that the Christ is Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God is King of all the earth.
God is King of all the earth.
All you peoples, clap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness, for the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth.
God is King of all the earth.
For King of all the earth is God. Sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne.
God is King of all the earth.
The princes of peoples are gathered together with the people of the God of Abraham, for gods are the guardians of the earth. He is supreme.
God is King of all the earth.
Alleluia. 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 I came from the Father and have come into the world. Now I am leaving the world and going back to the Father.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. Until now, you have not asked anything in my name. Ask and you will receive, so that your joy may be complete. I have told you this in figures of speech. The hour is coming when I will no longer speak to you in figures, but I will tell you clearly about the Father. On that day, you will ask in my name, and I do not tell you that I will ask the Father for you. For the Father himself loves you, because you have loved me and have come to believe that I came from God. I came from the Father and have come into the world. Now I am leaving the world and going back to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, we meet Apollos, a Jewish Christian who had been instructed in the way of the Lord Jesus Christ, but who knew only the baptism of John. When Apollos began to speak boldly about Jesus in the Jewish synagogue, he attracted the attention of Priscilla and Aquila, a married couple who were leaders of the Christian community in Ephesus. They took Apollos aside and explained the way of the Lord more accurately. Thus, Priscilla and Aquila gave Apollos the instruction and formation that he needed to be a more effective missionary. And today's reading notes that Apollos then was able to establish from scriptures that Jesus is the Messiah, the Christ. Apollos is to be commended for his openness to learning new things about the faith. He realized that Priscilla and Aquila had much to teach him, and he was a willing student. We too need to be open to learning new things about our faith. No matter how much we know, there is always more to learn. And we need to take advantage of the opportunities that are available to us. For example, during normal times, St. Denis offers several different opportunities for faith formation, including RCIA, which prepares non-Catholics to receive the sacraments of baptism, confirmation, and First Holy Communion. We also offer Alpha, which introduces people to the Christian faith. Moreover, we have a program called Adult Faith Formation for Everyone, which teaches the essentials of the Catholic faith that every adult Catholic needs to know and which prepares adults to receive the sacrament of confirmation. In addition, we have a Wednesday evening Bible study group, which usually focuses on a particular book of the Bible. During this time of the coronavirus, when everyone has to stay home, St. Denis is trying to figure out how to offer these various faith formation programs online. For example, this Wednesday at 8 p.m., our adult Bible study group will start meeting again online and will begin to study the Acts of the Apostles. Please check our website, stdenis.org, stdenis.org, in the next day or so for all of the details about how to participate in our Wednesday Bible study group. In today's first reading from Acts, Apollos needed further instruction and formation in order to evangelize more effectively. Likewise, we need ongoing instruction and faith formation in order to bring the good news of Jesus Christ more effectively to our family and friends, to our neighbors and coworkers, and to everyone in our lives. Please stand. Jesus told his disciples that whatever they ask the Father in his name will be given. Knowing this, we have the confidence to bring him our needs. For those discerning a vocation in the church, may God grant them wisdom and understanding. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governments and political leaders, may the Holy Spirit lead them in service of their communities, countries, and world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are grieving the loss of a loved one, may the joy and hope of the resurrection bring them solace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newly baptized in our community and for those who are preparing to receive the sacrament of baptism, may the Holy Spirit continue to bring them ever closer to God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, including Michael Burch, may they enjoy eternity in heaven with the risen Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who need our prayers, and for all of the prayer intentions listed in the comments section on Facebook and YouTube for this Mass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of love and mercy, we ask you to look kindly upon these prayers, which we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us,
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. For those of you at home, I encourage you to offer the sign of peace to others in your household, even if they're not watching Mass with you. Or you can offer the sign of peace to others in our virtual Mass community by typing something into the comments section on Facebook or YouTube. And we'll pause briefly here to allow you to do that. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a few announcements. I just want to thank you all of you at home for joining us for a Mass this morning. We celebrate a Mass here at St. Denis every weekday morning, Monday through Saturday at 8 a.m. And we celebrate two Masses on Sunday, live streamed at 10:30 a.m. with a cantor and organ and piano, and at 5:30 p.m. with more contemporary music for youths, young adults, and others. Please join us for one of our Sunday Masses tomorrow, because we are going to try something a little bit different. At the end of the Mass, the priest is going to stay on the live stream and is going to interact with people via the comments section on Facebook. So please join us for that. And beginning next week, the priests will start leading parishioners several days a week in different forms of praying using the platform Zoom. We are going to experiment with this new platform, new for us, Zoom, because it looks like it will give us an opportunity to draw the community together and build up our faith community, even though we are still having to stay at home because of the coronavirus. For example, on Tuesday, I will lead a gospel reflection prayer at 7 p.m., and we will use Zoom, and so I invite you to join me and join us Tuesday at 7 p.m. all of the details about what we're doing via live stream and otherwise will be on our website soon. Our website is stdenis.org, stdenis.org. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.